Hello friends, welcome to my channel. In this video I will cover GATE previous year paper strength of matter design of machine elements and engineering mechanics 2017 afternoon session I will cover. This is part 2. Question is, a machine component made of a ductile material is subjected to a variable loading with sigma minimum equal to minimum stress is minus 50 MPa and maximum stress sigma max equal to 50 MPa. If the corrected endurance limit and the yield strength for the material are sigma e dash equal to 100 MPa and sigma y equal to 300 MPa respectively, the factor of safety is how much? Factor of safety we have to calculate. So first, sigma mean stress equal to sigma max maximum stress plus minimum stress divided by 2. Its value is 50 minus 50 divided by 2, so it's 0. Variable stress sigma b equal to sigma max minus sigma mean divided by 2. 50 minus minus 50 divided by 2, so 100 by 2, it's 50 MPa. Then given corrected endurance limit, it's 100 MPa, yield strength, it's 300 MPa. We have to calculate factor of safety. Our formula is sigma mean divided by sigma yield plus sigma variable divided by corrected endurance limit equal to 1 by factor of safety. So put the values, 0 by sigma y is 300 plus sigma v variable is, we got 50 divided by sigma e dash, it's 100, it's 100 equal to 1 by factor of safety. If you will solve this one, we will get factor of safety equal to 2. This is our answer. Question is, a helical compression spring made of a wire of circular cross section is subjected to a compressive load. The maximum shear stress induced in the cross section of the wire is 24 MPa. For the same compressive load, if both the wire diameter and the mean coil diameter are doubled, the maximum shear stress in MPa induced in the cross sections of the wire is how much? Maximum shear stress. Initial case we got tau S1, it's 24 MPa. So we know from torsion equation T by J equal to tau S by R. From here J equal to, for circular cross section, it's pi by 32 d to the power 4. If we solve this one, we will get torque T equal to pi by 16 tau S dQ. So we know torque is force into distance. So load applied is P. For the same compressive load, let it be P into distance is d by 2 or R. Coil diameter, mean coil diameter divided by 2. It's equal to pi by 16 tau S dQ. This is transverse shear, torsional shear. Then if we solve this one, tau S we will get 8 P into D divided by pi dQ. So it's equal to tau S1, it's equal to 24 MPa megapascal. In second case, P is same here. P1 equal to P2 equal to P. Coil diameter is doubled. And wire diameter also doubled, 2D. So put the formula, put the values in the formulas. 8 into P is same, 2D divided by pi into 2D Q. So if you solve this one, we will get 1 by 4 into P into capital D divided by pi D Q, or 1 by 4 tau S1. So tau S1 value already is 24 divided by 4, we will get 6 MPa. 6 MPa is our answer. This is Rebate's eccentric loading case. A steel plate connected to a fixed channel using three identical, this is bolt case, bolt eccentric case, using three identical bolts A, B, C, carries a load of 6 kN as shown in the figure. Considering the effect of direct load and moment, the magnitude of resultant shear force on belt C is how much? So first we have to calculate the center of gravity, then primary shear force, then secondary shear force, then we have to calculate the resultant shear force at C. C is here. Let this force is P at center of gravity or B point. B point we will resolve it as P and one more P here. Then we will get one direct load P and one moment. One couple we will get, clockwise couple. This distance is, let it be E. Already E value given. Couple value is P into E. Clockwise couple we will get, and one direct load. Because of this direct shear load, we will get primary shear stress. Primary shear stress like this we will get in each of the three bolts. PP. PP is primary shear force. Primary shear force. Its value is total load divided by number of bolts, P by N. Its number of bolt is 3, so 2 kN. This is primary shear force. And twisting moment, it's equal to P into E. So we know secondary shear force PS is proportional to the distance from CG. If we calculate the CG of the 3 volt, we will get the CG at B point. So the distance from the bolt is R. Distance of CG from the individual bolt, this is the value of R. For C volt, R value is B to C distance. So for fast volt or PA, secondary shear force, it's proportional to R1, or R1 or BC, distance is BC. And for PB, secondary shear force is R2, or distance is AB, whatever you can take, no problem. Then for C volt, secondary shear load is proportional to R3, or distance is BC. Sorry, for PA, it's AB distance, and for B, R2 is 0, because CG at B itself. So for C, it's R3 equal to BC. So secondary shear load, PA double dash by R1 equal to constant, like that P PB double dash divided by R2 equal to constant. So PB double dash and PC double dash we will get. So we know P into E equal to PA double dash into R1 plus P2 PB double dash into R2, R2 value is 0, plus PC double dash secondary shear load at C into distance from CG to the C point, it's BC, it's R3, and from here we already got PB double dash and PC double dash, put the values, we will get P1 double dash by R1 whole into PA double dash by R1 whole into R1 square plus R2 square plus R3 square. So from here we will get PA double dash. Like this, for PC double dash secondary shear load at 3, at C point we can get PC double dash equal to P into E into R3 divided by R1 square plus R2 square plus R3 square. Put the values. So P value already given 6 kN into E value is 250 into R3 is 50. Distance of BC divided by 50 square plus R2 is at CG, so it's 0 plus 50 square. If you solve this one, you will get 15 kN. So PC secondary shear load at C, it's 15 kN. Already primary shear load we got 2 kN at C. So resultant at C equal to primary shear load plus secondary shear load. So 2 plus 15, we will get 17 kN. 17 kN is our answer. So from option 17 kN, C is the answer. Question is, a single plate clutch has a friction disc with inner and outer radius of 20 mm and 40 mm respectively. The friction lining in the disc is made in such a way that the coefficient of friction mu varies radially as mu equal to 0.01 R, where R is in mm. The clutch needs to transmit a friction torque of 18.85 kN into mm. As for uniform pressure theory, the pressure in MPa on the disc is how much? For some theories I will describe, after that I will solve this question. This is a single plate clutch. This is inner radius Ri and outer radius Ro. Take a elementary strip. Here this is dr, small dr, and this distance is r. So area of the friction surface for the elementary ring. First, area of the friction surface for the elementary ring. For this elementary ring, area is, radius is r and ring thickness is dr. So 2 pi r small r dr, this is the area of the friction surface for the elementary ring. Then normal axial force on the ring dw, it's equal to pressure into area. Pressure into area. So pressure is P, area is 2 pi r dr. Then frictional force acting tangentially to the ring of radius r, it's mu into w. Fr is mu into W. Friction formula we will use here. Mu into dW. For the ring, it's dW. So dW is mu into P into area 2 pi r dr. Then frictional torque on the ring of the elemental ring is frictional force into distance. Fr into r is the distance. So mu P into 2 pi r dr into r. Finally we will get mu P into 2 pi r square dr. Then total frictional torque. Total frictional torque, if you integrate the elementary strip from inner radius to outer radius, then you will get total frictional torque of the clutch. So ri to ro 2 pi mu p r square dr. So integrate it. Mu value also given. Put the values of mu. Mu is varying 2 pi p. Mu value is 0.01 into r r square dr. So rq you will get. So finally we have to integrate 2 pi to 0.01 to p into rq dr. Lower limit is ri, upper limit is ro. Tf value given 18.85 into 10 to power 3 equal to 0.01 into 2 pi p into rq integrate ro to the power 4 ri to the power 4 divided by 4. Ro and ri value also given 40 and 20. So finally p equal to 4 into 18.85 into 10 to power 3 divided by 0.01 into 2 into pi into 40 ro 40 to the power 4 20 to the power 4 ri inner radius. You will get answer 0.5 newton per mm square or 0.5 megapascal. This is the answer. So from the option, no, this is numerical question, so here you put 0.5 megapascal. No need to put the unit, only 0.5. You just another two questions left. I will solve in next part 3. I will solve. Thank you friends, thank you for watching my video. Thank you.